Hi, I'm Sarah with the Maryland Department of Natural Resources Maryland Stream Waders Program. Stream Waders is the volunteer component of the Maryland Biological Stream Survey. Our volunteers assist biologists by collecting benthic macroinvertebrate samples, which are then used to help determine stream quality and health. After collecting and preserving the samples, volunteers turn them back into us, where our biologists identify them in the lab and assign each site an Index of Biotic Integrity score, or IBI. Now, I've gathered together some friends to help me demonstrate how to properly collect a sample. But before we do that, let's make sure you've got the right equipment. We'll make sure you've got D-net, a nice pair of gloves, sieve bucket, you want a labeled benthic bucket, and ethanol to preserve your sample. Our volunteers pick what watershed they're going to sample from, the stream, and the site they want to sample. Now, from each site, they select 20 square feet of the best available habitat. Now, that's an important part. You want to make sure you're getting the best habitat and that you're sampling it correctly. If the bugs are there, we want to find them. Now, some of the best places to look are riffles, leaf packs, woody debris, root wads, submerged aquatic vegetation, and undercut banks. And each of these habitats requires a slightly different sampling technique. So let's go.
Hi, I'm Luke. I'm with Maryland Biological Stream Survey, and I'm here to help you learn how to sample a leaf pack. Right here, I have some old decomposed leaves and some newer leaves that have just fallen. You want to make sure you sample the more decomposed leaves when you're collecting a sample. The macroinvertebrates can eat those much more easily than they can the newer, less decomposed leaves. If you come down here, you'll notice I'll go ahead and start picking them up with my gloved hand and start moving them into the net. You want to make sure you do not get any rocks or anything like that, unless you decide to scrub them off like that. And just move them into your net, and then place your sample into your sieve bucket. And then you can just take the leaves and gently wipe them off, make sure you get those bugs off and into your sieve bucket. And that's how it works.
Hi, I'm John, and I'm with the Maryland Biological Stream Survey, and I'm gonna show you how to sample a riffle. Visualizing your 1 square foot sample is real easy with a riffle. You just look at your D-net, and the bottom of it is about 1 foot. So you stick that on your stream bottom. Make sure the net of the bag opens downstream, you're facing upstream, and you can visualize your 1 square foot right here. Any large cobble or anything on the sample site, you want to pick up and brush off with your gloves. Be real thorough, get in all those little cracks, and make sure you get all those little bugs swept into your net. After that, you want to step into your little site and disturb the substrate with your feet. Again, making sure everything goes into that net. So that's done, take your net and you sweep it through the area. When you get to your site, riffles of different depths and different velocities can support different species. This is a slow, shallow riffle right here. Here you have a faster riffle. You'll notice the water is moving quicker. You can actually hear it and you can see bubbles. And this could support different species in the slower riffle.
Hi, I'm Catherine. I'm with the Maryland Biological Stream Survey, and I'm going to show you how to sample woody debris. Here we have a small piece of woody debris. It's been submerged for a while, so the bugs have had a chance to colonize it. What you want to do is you want to position the end so that it's sitting near or in your net, and when the net catches the bugs, it'll be downstream. So you reach in with your gloves, you rub all the rough surfaces on the woody debris and make sure that all the bugs are taken off and they'll float downstream into your net. Here we have a piece of large woody debris. For this one, you want to put your net on the downstream side of the woody debris, reach in, rub all the rough surfaces with your gloves to dislodge all the insects hidden there. You want to go in then, scrape along it with your net, and then sweep to catch anything that's floating still. And that's one sample.
Hi, I'm Patrick with the Maryland Biological Stream Survey, and I'm going to show you how to sample an undercut bank. Undercut banks are created when moving water erodes or cuts out bank material underneath the surface of the water. This creates a cavity that has a vertical bank, a nearly vertical bank, or a C-shaped bank. This provides excellent habitat for a number of aquatic organisms. Now, in order to sample an undercut bank, you're going to want to face the bank, and starting from the bottom, kind of in a scraping motion, move from bottom to top, dislodging organisms in the sample.
Hi, I'm Sarah with the Maryland Biological Stream Survey, and I'm going to show you how to sample a root wad. When you're ready to sample your root wad, you approach it from the downstream direction, take your net, slip it under, and get the whole root wad into your net. Remember to use your gloves. Once you have it in your net, you want to give it a swish, a vigorous swishing. Really try to work everything loose. You go ahead and take your fingers, almost comb through it, as if you were brushing your hair. Be sure you get it down to the very end. And that's your sample. Now, if you come across some shorter root wads, you can just go ahead, work your net underneath it, and give some jabbing motions. Again, you're trying to dislodge anything that might be clinging on in there. There you go. Now, if you have some smaller root wads, it may not make up a square foot. So you want to be sure you sample two or three, however many it takes to make up a square foot. When you finish collecting your 20 square feet, or if your net gets full, you want to go ahead and dump it into your sieve bucket. And when you're doing that, go ahead and completely invert it into your sieve bucket. Go ahead, rinse it around. You're going to want to rinse everything off. Everything that was in this net, we want to go into the sieve bucket. So you can go ahead and use your benthic bucket and rinse that off. A little bit from the inside, just to push that all on through. You've even got to take a look. There can be a lot of little things here, caddisflies and stuff, that can cling to your net. You want to make sure that they go into your sieve bucket. Process your sample. Now, the more organic matter that you have in your sample, the more diluted your ethanol is going to be and the faster it's going to rot. So we want to get as much of this organic matter out as possible. Leaves, anything like this, you want to give it a swish in your bucket, look it over both sides, it can be a lot of little tiny things, and you want to make sure that they stay in the sample. So any sticks, anything that that can, you know, use up the ethanol or that isn't going to fit in the bucket, you're going to want to get those out. Again, give them a quick look over, swish in your bucket, you can toss them. Rocks, you want to make sure rocks aren't going into the bucket. Be sure you look these over carefully. A lot of caddisfly cases can really cling tight, so you want to make sure you scrape those off into the sieve bucket and go ahead and toss the rocks to the side. You're going to get down to where you've just got this that's not it, this fine material. You may have trouble getting that out of your sieve bucket. What you can do, you can lift it up so that there's still water in it. Kind of give it a gentle swishing. You don't want to do this. That's a washing machine. We don't want to do that. You can break up a lot of the critters that are in here. They can be pretty soft-bodied for all that they withstand the rough life in the stream. And if you still have some of that fine material in there, that's okay. That can stay in the sample. Now, with all the habitats that we sampled, these are good habitats for a lot of aquatic organisms. And not everything that we catch, we want to keep in the sample. We're trying to collect macroinvertebrates. So a fish, we don't want that in the sample. They can go out. See? If you get a crayfish, macroinvertebrate, we definitely want him to stay in the sample. So he can go in our benthic bucket. You could possibly kick up a salamander larva in some of your riffles. Definitely a vertebrate. Don't want them in our sample. Now, if you get mussels in your sample, mussels are tricky. Almost all of the species that we have in Maryland are either rare, threatened, or endangered. So even though they are an invertebrate, we don't want to kill them. So you're going to go ahead and put them back in the stream. So after you finish processing your sample, you want to take and try to get everything that's in this sieve bucket into your benthic bucket. So we're going to go ahead. Scrape that all in there. There's still some on the bottom, so we're going to give it another swish. You want to try and keep as much water as possible out of the sample. Again, it's going to dilute your ethanol and make it more likely that your sample is going to rot. Now that we've taken all this time to collect our sample, we want to make sure that it's properly preserved. So we're back up at our vehicle, we've got our ethanol in. You want to make sure that you've got about half sortate and half ethanol. If you have so much that you need to divide your sample into two buckets, that's fine. We would rather have two buckets of a well-preserved sample than one bucket full of rotten mush. So I've got my ethanol in. My outside label is written in pencil on the side of the bucket, not on the lid. And I've also got the inside bucket, again, written in pencil. So I'm going to go ahead and put that inside. Put this lid down on tight. And we're going to go ahead and give it a gentle mixing. You want to make sure that that ethanol gets all throughout so it preserves everything. And you want to do this gently. Again, you don't want to be really rough, shake this up like you got a pair of maracas. And that's your sample. I'm Sarah with the Maryland Biological Stream Survey, Maryland Stream Waders. If you have any further questions, you can visit our website, dnr.maryland.gov, search for Stream Waders.